In the previous lecture, we have studied about the morphological structure of the pituitary gland or the master gland. Then today, we have learned about the next part of this pituitary gland, that means the internal structure of the pituitary gland. Actually, morphologically, this pituitary gland structure becomes divided by means of the two lobes, that means the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. The anterior lobe is known as the adenohypophysis, posterior lobe is known as the neurohypophysis. And these two lobes, again divided by means of the different parts. And these parts may be the adenohypophysis itself divided by means of three parts. And these are the, this major part is pars distalis. This is very important part. Then pars tuberalis. Then this is the part intermedia, pars intermedia. And one more lobe is present on the pituitary gland, that means the posterior lobe. And this posterior lobe is present here. This is known as the neurohypophysis. And actually, this neurohypophysis have been again divided by means of the different parts. And these parts are the major part of the neurohypophysis, pars nervosa. Then the pars infundibulum, that as a funnel circle part. And the next one is the median immense. Actually, the median immense is the diffused part which is present in the pituitary gland. So this pituitary gland itself have been morphologically divided by means of this anterior and the posterior lobe, adenohypophysis and the neurohypophysis. So the adenohypophysis, so this is the adenohypophysis, is the largest lobe, no doubt. About 75% of the gland is acquired by means of the adenohypophysis. And the outer growth of the adenohypophysis is takes place by means of the rachis pouch. Actually, adenohypophysis is divided by means of the pars tuberalis. So this pars tuberalis is the collar. That means this part. The collar around the infundibulum, below the hypothalamus. Then the pars distalis, it is the, so this is the pars distalis actually. And this pars distalis is the largest region of the adenohypophysis. It is made up of cords. Actually, this, that means the pars distalis have been constructed of the different cords. And these cords becomes made by means of the epithelioid secretory cells. And these epithelioid secretory cells are separated by reticular connective tissue. So this is the reticules, zaridar. This reticular connective tissues containing blood sinusoids. Then pars intermedia between the two lobes. It is narrow cleft. So this is the cleft. This cleft present here between them. And this is non-functional in the human being. Then neurohypophysis itself consists of the median immense, infundibulum. And the very important, that means the part is the nervosa, this part. So it is the lower part of the neurohypophysis. It contains axons. These are the axons. Okay. And in between the pituicytes, axonic fibers end in knob-like structure called as the hearing bodies. So the axons of the particular, that means the pituicytes, have been consisted of these structures, and these structures are known as the hearing bodies. Actually, this pituitary gland secrete the different types of the hormones. Actually, both the lobes, adenohypophysis as well as the neurohypophysis, have to secrete separately the different types of the hormones. And these hormones are, the adenohypophysis secrete the hormone. The first hormone is STH, or somatotropic hormone, growth hormone. TSH, that means the six hormones secreted by the adenohypophysis. Thyroid stimulating hormone. ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone. Then LTH, leukotropic or mammotropic or prolactin hormone. Then GTH, gonadotropin hormone. Gonadotropin hormone itself consists of the FSH, LH, ICSH. And the last one is the MSH. TH. So first harmony is the STH. We have studied one by one. So the harmony study becomes studied by means of the point wise. The first point is the, what is the target organ of this harmony? So the target organ of the STH is the tissue, muscles, bones. Actually this STH secreted by the adenohyphysis consists of the acidophil cells. The function of this hormone is the to stimulate growth of the body or increase cell division or increase the amino acid uptake and protein synthesis, increase the glucose level, increase the absorption of the calcium for the growth of the bone and stimulate all anabolic functions. Whenever such type of the growth hormone, STH hormone, becomes secreted hyper or the hypo, that means excessive or deficient in the body, they have caused different diseases in the children's as well as adult. In children, the disorder takes place due to the hyper secretion. Just the secret zala, samjahi STH lahan mulamadhe. Generally in the childhood, this, that means the hormone is secreted excessively, then and then the children have been suffered by the disease, and this disease is known as the gigantism. What is meant by gigantism? So in this disease, abnormally the height of the student, height of the particular child becomes increased. Okay, so hyper, this is the height of the child, he hypo, and this is the hyper. So this child becomes heighted very abnormally due to the hyper secretion of the GH, known as the gigantism. The example is the Sultan Kosem, but the earliest example is the Robert Vadalo of USA, was height about 8 feet and 11 inch tall. So this is due to hyper secretion of the GTH. In adult, it causes acromegaly. That means the hyper secretion of this STH takes place in the adult person. Then and then the adult person have been again to produce some abnormal elongation of the limbs, lower jaw, cheeks, and the total behavior or look of this adult person looks like gorilla appearance. So these, that means the diseases have been occurred due to the hyper secretion of the GH. Then the hypo means kami secret zala samja lahan mulamadhe he hormone, tar kay hota, the generally in the children this hormone becomes hyposecreted, then they have been caused the disease known as the dwarfism. बुटकेपणा, डॉर्फिझम बुटकेपणा, ती मुलं बुटके होतात की साधारणपणे हे असे डॉर्फिझम. आणि मग ती उंची किती असते, तर 3 ते 4 फुटाच्या आतमध्ये. द डॉर्फिझम इन चाइल्ड मे बी ऑब्झर्व्ह बाय मीन्स ऑफ द टू टाईप, अँड दीज आर दी लोरियन टाईप, मेंटली नॉर्मल डॉर्फ बट नॉर्मल, अँड दी फोर्चलीच टाईप, दॅट मीन्स मेंटली एबनॉर्मल विथ ओबेसिटी. ओबेसिटी दॅट मीन लठ्ठपणा, तर ही मुलं थोडी लठ्ठ असतात आणि मेंटलीसुद्धा एबनॉर्मल असतात. तर दिस इज ड्यू टू दी हायपो सिक्रेशन ऑफ दी STH. देन ॲक्रोमॅक्रिया, इट इज अगेन कॉज्ड इन द ॲडल्ट ड्यू टू दी हायपो सिक्रेशन ऑफ दी STH. दॅट मीन्स इन दिस पर्सन द हँड, फीट ऑर फेस बिकम्स व्हेरी स्मॉल. सो दीज आर सम डिसीजेस ऑकर ड्यू टू दी हायपर अँड दी हायपो सिक्रेशन ऑफ दी STH. Then another one hormone is the thyroid stimulating hormone or STH hormone. So this STH hormone, then what is the target organ? Thyroid gland. Then the STH secreted by the basophil or the thyrotropin cells of the pituitary or the adenohyphysis. Actual function of this gland, the functions are, it stimulate growth of the thyroid gland, then regulate rate of the iodine uptake, then synthesis of the thyroxine. These are very important. That means the functions performed by the TSH. Then again, some disorders are occurred due to the hyper and the hyposecretion. The hypersecretion leads the Graves' disease. Actually, the particular, the first and the major part of this thyroid gland we have studied in the next point. Then we have already studied the thyroid gland. So, oversecretion of the thyroxine TSH cause the hyperthyroidism or the Graves' disease, and the hyposecretion leads to thyroid atrophy or hypothyroidism. And the hypothyroidism is nothing but the cretinism in the children. Actually, cretinism. So the cretinism means what? The slow growth of the particular child. They have been very slow in the there in the speech formation, holding of the neck, then the dentition or mental retard. So these are some symptoms observed in the cretinism suffered some children due to the hyposecretion, kami secret zala samza, TSH bola madhe tar. And in adult, myxoedema. Prouda madhe zar kami secret zala tar myxoedema. Ata kharthar, this myxoedema is also known as the Gould's disease. And actually, this myxoedema suffered person looks like puffiness, obesity, fall of the hairs, or maybe dry skin. So such type of the symptoms are also observed. Then the next hormone is the ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, which is again secreted by the adenohyphysis. And the target organ is the cortex of the adrenal gland, secreted by the basophils or corticotropes. Functions. So the functions of the ACTH are stimulate growth of adrenal cortex, regulate the amino or glucocorticoid and the mineralocorticoid. So they regulate synthesis of the glucocorticoid and the mineralocorticoid are the major functions performed by the ACTH. Glucocorticoid have to regulate the carbohydrate and the protein or the protein metabolism, and the mineralocorticoid regulate the ionic balance in the body. Again, some disorders are also formed due to the hyper and hyposecretion of the ACTH. The hyposecret, kami secret zahala tar kay hota baga? Rheumatoid arthritis, Addison's disease, that means degeneration of the adrenal cortex, and the hypersecretion mula leads to Cushing syndrome. So this is the some symptoms of the Cushing syndrome here. So the Cushing syndrome, the face becomes a moon face, then the weakness, then the obesity, pot moto, the hath pai chotasta, then the fat deposition on the lower part of the neck, actually buffalo hump, pot ek the motasna. The heji kaya hai, the baryapaiki observation hai, ya Cushing, ya syndrome chet, symptoms. Cushing syndrome kashamu to zor jaast secret zhala tar ani Addison's madhe baryapaiki he ashe symptoms kya adratat. General Addison's syndrome have been causes the symptoms like this, the skin coloration on the hand, then the base of the teeth becomes decaying like this. So such symptoms may be occur due to the Addison's as well as the Cushing syndrome or the hyper and the hyper secretion of the ACTH. Then the next, that means the hormone is the GTH, gonadotropic hormone. This is again very important. The target organs are gonads. Gonads may be testes or the ovaries, secreted by basophil cells. Function, regulation of normal growth and functioning of the gonads. These GTH hormones are of two types. These are FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, and LH, luteinizing hormone. So the FSH actually secreted in both male and the female. In male, it stimulate development of the seminiferous tubular spermatogenesis, that means the production of the sperm. And in female, it stimulate the development of graafian follicle and secretion of the estrogen. Then the LH, so the LH is the luteinizing hormone, and this LH again perform the function like ovulation from ovary, formation of corpus luteum, or maintain the pregnancy. So the LH in male have been perform the function like stimulate the interstitial cells, that is the Leydig cells of the testes, to secrete the sex hormone testosterone. And whenever deficiency of the LH in the male have caused infertility, then the next hormone which is secreted by the adenohypothesis is the LTH. So the LTH is also known as the prolactin hormone or lactotropic hormone. Target organ, mammary gland, secreted by lactotrophs or acidophils, and functions performed by the LTH hormone is to stimulate the growth of the mammary gland. So stimulate the growth of the mammary gland. Then the formation and secretion of the milk after the childbirth, then induce strong affection for young ones by the mother, and the secretion of the LTH may be regulated by the PRF. And very last hormone secreted by the adenohypothesis is the MSH, melanophore stimulating hormone. Melanophores are the pigment producing cells. So the target organ is the skin. The function, control pigmentation, aplekat dila rang, yenasati coloration, yenasati hormones cha upyog hoto. MSH is functional in fish, amphibians, reptiles, but non functional in man. MSH may affect nervous tissue excitability in the mammals. And the regulation of this MSH takes place by the controlling of the hypothalamic factor. So, these are the six hormones which are secreted by the adenohypothesis of the pituitary gland. And the next hormones which are secreted by the neurohypophysis. And these hormones are, the first hormone is oxytocin. Actually, this oxytocin hormone is also known as quick birth hormone. Target organ is uterus. Actually, functions, it stimulate contraction of smooth muscles or the myometrium of uterus during normal delivery. Then it stimulate and increase labor pains for quick birth. So these are the functions. And also one more function of this oxytocin is the, after the birth, the oxytocin have to stimulate the mammary gland to eject the milk. So this and these functions are performed by the oxytocin. Then the next and the last hormone of the neurohypothesis is the vasopressin or ADH, antidiuretic hormone. This hormone is also known as pitresin. It is antidiuretic because it is against dilute urine. Target organ is nephrons of the kidney. And the function which are performed by this hormone are the increased reabsorption of the water in kidney, then contraction of the muscles of arterioles, exert pressure effect and increase BP. It regulate water balance by reducing output of urine. Actually, the hyposecretion, kami secrete zhalyavar kay hoto, the hyposecretion of ADH increase amount of urine. So there is more urination. And this condition, that more urination due to hyposecretion of the ADH have caused the diabetes insipidus. Diabetes insipidus, or it is also known as the diuresis condition. And this person have been suffered by the polydipsia. Polydipsia means increased thirst, tahan vadte. And this person have been again, and that means due to the AD secretion becomes in stress and emotional condition. So these different hormones are secreted by the pituitary gland, consist of the two lobes, and these two lobes are the adenohypophysis and the neurohypophysis. So once again we have that in the looks like the pituitary structure of pituitary gland, and this pituitary gland itself consists of these lobes, and these lobes may be the adenohypophysis, neurohypophysis. This adenohypophysis have been consist of the pars distalis, pars intermedia, then tuberalis, and these different parts have secret such type of the hormones. Actually majorly the pars distalis have to secrete such type of the hormones like the GH, then the TSH, ACTH, then LH or FSH. Actual TSH, thyroid gland, ACTH, adrenal gland, then FSH, non-gonadal like ovary, then FSH or ICSH on testes, then GH on bones or the muscles, then the prolactin hormone on the mammary gland, or ADH of the neurohypophysis of the pituitary gland affect on the kidney function, then oxytocin on the ovary or the uterus, on the uterus, and after the birth on the mammary gland. So these different organs have been performing its function according to the controlling of such hormones which are secreted by the pituitary gland, having consist of the adenohypophysis and the neurohypophysis. So this much information about the pituitary gland, and the one more information about the pineal gland. Actually pineal gland here, so the pineal gland, which is again the very important gland present below the diencephalon, roof of the diencephalon, not the below, roof. Diencephalon is a part of the granthi. It located between the two cerebral hemisphere. This is the hemisphere, and a hemisphere is the pineal gland. So pineal gland here, this is the pineal gland between the this side, right side cerebral hemisphere, and the left side hemisphere, between them this pineal gland is present. Actually this is the pineal gland, and this pineal gland is very sensitive to the biochemical signals of light. It secretes a hormone called as melatonin. So the melatonin hormone is again very important hormone, and it also known as sleep hormone. Melatonin is derived from tryptophan and plays very important role in the regulation of the biological clock, of our body. So it helps in maintaining the normal rhythm of sleep wake cycle, and also influence body temperature, metabolism, and the reproductive cycle. So this is the one more gland present in the brain region or the nervous region, and this is known as the pineal gland. So this is the pineal gland. So we have studied in this lecture the particular endocrine gland, structure of the endocrine gland, lobes of the endocrine gland, then the parts of these lobes, then the hormones of secreted by the lobes, then whenever the hyper and the hypo secretion of these hormones takes place in the body have caused different diseases, and lastly we have to study about the structure of the